Mr. Speaker, we have been informed that the Honorable Lito Atienza of the party list Buhay wishes to rise on a matter of personal and collective privilege.
May I ask, Honorable Atienza, what is the nature of your privilege?
We just would like to clarify and at the same time answer the allegations aired yesterday that this representation has been sowing fake news to the chamber. So if given a chance, and I'd like to beg you to give us a chance to clarify the matter.
Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, under Section 102 of our rules, the request of personal and collective privilege by the Honorable Atienza is in order. I move that we recognize the Honorable Lito Atienza of Party List Buhay.
Representative Lito Atienza is given 10 minutes.
Maraming salamat po, Mr. Speaker. And thank you, Mr. Majority Floor Leader, for understanding our position. Yesterday, we deliberated on a privileged speech delivered by Congresswoman Herrera D. And she mentioned about the growing problem of people shying away from health centers to have their children vaccinated. And there seems to be a resurging polio problem among our children. And as a matter of our knowledge of the issues, why people are shying away from health centers today, we interpellated Congresswoman D. And in our interpellation, we explained, to our knowledge, mothers and women are shying away from vaccinations and campaigns of government to have children vaccinated, simply because people have lost confidence and the DOH has lost credibility on this particular type of service. Because on two occasions, people were taken advantage of without their knowledge. One, during the tetanus toxoid, massive vaccination of women of age 14 to 44. And it turned out, as we exposed it then, yung bakuna nila ay mayroong pampabaog. 20% of women who were vaccinated are supposed to be sterilized. And that was their only way to really reduce the number of Filipinos being born. We fought that outside and in court, and we proved our point that there are vials of tetanus toxoid vaccine which are being used on our women, innocent as they are. 20% were laced with HCG element, which have no place in a tetanus, anti-tetanus vaccine. Yung po'y pampabaog. Yung mga tinamaan nun ay hindi na nagbuntis. Meron po ako mga kilala na nabiktima dyan. So, that was score number one. And then, sometime in 2015 and 16, government again went on a massive vaccination of children, supposedly to protect them from dengue. Marami po nagbabakuna, yung iba sa pilitan, pinabakunahan. Ano po ang naging bunga? Hindi pala dapat binabakunahan ng Dengvaxia ang isang bata kung hindi pa nagkakaroon ng dengue. Otherwise, they would be exposing themselves to contaminating each other with dengue, or rather developing dengue simply because of their exposure to Dengvaxia. Who said this? Sanofi itself, the manufacturer of the vaccine. Hindi po ako. Yan po ang deklarasyon ng Sanofi Pharmaceuticals, a foreign company, when they said, we did not say that this was going to solve the problem of dengue coming into the picture in the country. It will not make the children immune, even. In fact, they will have more chances of having dengue if they were vaccinated. Yan po sinabi nung Sanofi. E binanggit ko rin po yan. Kaya po tayo ngayon ay may problema. Ang mga ina at hindi nakakalimot doon sa tetanus toxoid at yung mga ina na hindi pa rin nalilimutan ang Dengvaxia scandal. Scandal because lumabas ang katotohanan sa ating investigasyon. Investigasyon ng Kongresyong ito. We investigated that particular issue. It came out very clearly that they rushed the immunization program. They were catching up with the elections of 2016. Pinilit nilang bakunahan, maski na ayaw magpabakuna, binigyan ng quota ang mga congressmen, 200,000 ka, 500,000, 1 million ka, para lamang magastos ang pera. E yan po naman ay pumutok na ngayon. At sinasabi ng mga ina, bago sila maniwala ulit sa DOH, ay marami dapat gawin ang bagong pamunuan ng Department of Health. Ako naman ay natutuwa sapagkat ginagawa ni Secretary Duque ang lahat upang mabawi ang tiwala ng mga mamamayan. Now, the lady who stood up yesterday branded my information that I was carrying to the chamber as nothing but fake news. Ganyan. That is unfair. Coming from a member of Congress, she should have respected my opinion as I would have respected hers. But since she branded it as fake news, I'm willing to prove this in any forum. Umili na siya. I will prove that she is wrong. And she is guilty of some wrongdoing in government. If she proves that I have infected this chamber with fake news, I'm willing to be prosecuted and I'm willing to resign my position. But if I am able to prove in that debate that I'm inviting her to join me in, she has to answer for the Dengvaxia deaths and the dengue deaths.
Point of order, Mr. Speaker.
Of our children.
Mr.
Otherwise,
point of order.
I will personally prosecute
her. Mr. Speaker,
her.
Point of order,
Majority,
Mr. Speaker.
Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, what rule is the subject of the point of order
Mr.
of the
Speaker,
lady?
Mr. Speaker, today is not a Monday. May I know why the Honorable Atienza is standing up and again spreading misinformation that tetanus toxoid causes sterility.
Mr. Speaker,
the leader.
Mr. Speaker, as I prefaced before the introduction, the Honorable Atienza is rising under Rule 102 of our rules, where he availed of the right to speak on a matter of personal and collective privilege, on a matter about his reputation. With that, Mr. Speaker, everything is in order and the Honorable Atienza has the floor.
Mr. Speaker, with the answer of the Majority Leader, allow me to enlighten him that our rules say no matter can be discussed without a quorum. I therefore move that we call the roll.
Session suspended.
We can call the roll a million times. I'll still challenge
Mr. Speaker, may I request the Secretary General to bring the Honorable Colleague out of this floor. We are not on session and he keeps on talking.